in this video I will show you what's new in the Garmin tool. So two main features is first is improved symmetrize, and second one is ability to pin vertex group vertex cloth to vertex loops. So in here I have loop, and because it is pinned with this new ability, the kit is not falling down. So I will quickly show you maybe how the symmetrize, what's changed in the symmetrize. So in the past you would have to manually add points on the center of x-axis for symmetrize to work. If this point would be removed, the symmetrize would not work, but now I can delete this, move this outside, use symmetrize, and you see it is properly mirrored. And I made sure that this works in easy way, easy and convenient way, because symmetrize is very often used when modeling cloth sewing patterns. So I made sure it is easy to use, and just you don't have to manually fix or do any like manual points additions. So yeah, this tool will work also with more complicated patterns. So maybe let's say I will add a hole on one side. So I just duplicate, I just duplicated this part of curve, make this cyclic, and you see we have now the hole inside, and the symmetrize will work okay with that. I can maybe even duplicate this, symmetrize again, and you see it works even like this. And just remember that for more complicated curves, so let's say we have curve like this, it is more complicated because it is going through the center in few places, it is not just one simple shape. So in this case, if I use symmetrize, it won't work properly. Then remember that there is shift option, shift click option. It is more advanced algorithm that will work better with more complicated sewing patterns, but remember that this shift click won't preserve the sewings. So if you can, use the normal click, and if it fails, then only then use shift click. So okay, that explains the symmetrize. Now let's go to the constraining and pinning of the vertex loops. So maybe I will open a simple scene. In here we have triangulated mesh, and this cloth is pinned to the center loop. So when I simulate, we have the effect like this. So now we can quickly create those loops like this by just simply maybe duplicating curve, and in the curve properties just setting fill mode to none, and that's it. Now when I triangulate this won't be filled because the curve fill mode is set to none. And also it is good to know that it doesn't has to be 3D, it doesn't has to be 2D, it can be 3D curve. And when I triangulate this, so let's preview the settings. When I triangulate this, maybe with lower resolution, convert to mesh, you see that this curve is not flat, but it still works. So yeah, you may wonder when it is useful. So I will show you another example. So in here, the problem was in the past that it would be hard to make this loop stay at this place, because maybe I could add another strip of geometry and add vertex group with some shrinking factor in the cloth properties. But there would be no guarantee that it would not slide down. So that's why I made this ability to actually it was requested by one user to add this ability for constraining movement of the cloth. So I will just quickly show you how the setup. we have the scarf. It is then vertex group is generated for it, and then this vertex group is just set in cloth properties for pinning. So let's preview the savings. This is the how the savings look. Then this name of this part is named top constraint. So in the vertex group, I actually use top constraint and two other loops for pinning effect. So we will have pin group generated in the mesh. When I go to mesh, you see in here we have the pin vertex group, and then in cloth properties it is used for pinning. So maybe I will show you how this would look without pinning. And let's simulate. And you see it doesn't just stick to the body. It is going down, but if I enable the pinning, it gives us more predictable result, and the loop is exactly in the place we want it to be. So yeah, another simple feature is I added ability to just disable or enable saving patterns. So in here I have some sleeves with the savings defined, but I just wanted to quickly see how this skirt would look without them, so I can disable them with this button. So let's maybe enable to show how it will look now with the sleeves. And on the first, I triangulated the mesh, generated the mesh, and if I simulate, you see that previously disabled geometry is now here. So yeah, those are the main features, and just remember that those constraint loops, they don't have to be used actually for pinning. They can be, because it is generating new vertex group, so you can use this vertex group for any cloth data property. So in this case I use this for pinning, but you can plug this anywhere in here, this new vertex group, for example for shrinking if you want, and then this loop will shrink. So I guess this may create also interesting effects. So yeah, that covers the new features, so symmetrize and ability to generate 2D or 3D curves that are not like filled, and the ability to disable or enable saving patterns. Hope you find this useful, and see ya.